Oh no, my game window. There, that should be it. Yeah, there we go. All right, let's get started. I've got some time today. I have like 2.5 hours, roughly. So we should be able to make some pretty good progress here. We left off on Per Aspera Ad Astra. We are at Elevated Expectations, rank 8, whatever that means. So let's see how we're looking. So, Per Aspera Ad Astra's space. It's real hard to say no to the space start, because we're going to be gated hard on trade routes, and we're also going to need a bunch of tritium. So, I feel like this has got to be the choice. It's not the only tritium. There's, you know, other stuff that you can use, but tritium's got to be, like, the easiest way to go about it. Who we got for leaders? So, regional buildings costing 15% less is spaceports. Spaceports being 15% cheaper might actually be pretty good. Getting free science production for robots, it may be also pretty good. Earthwork's probably not going to do a lot as the first leader. Modular apartment's pretty useless, so I'm picking between, like, and honestly, it's certainly like another place I can go. So I was watching one of the VODs, and I'm like, they can't see the icons. What if I go, like, here, and I'll work it out later? So, modular apartments is not going to do much for us. We're going to be a long ways off of making those. And Earthworks isn't going to do anything, because your first city very rarely has rocks. We could check if our first city has rocks in it, I guess. Yeah, it doesn't. So, his skills do nothing for us, whereas Gustav's skills are just, like, pretty good. And I think his specialization is slightly worse, but it's not bad, because there are space projects that cost science. So, I think that's going to be a pretty reasonable Gustav pick to start with. We want to prioritize power for sure. We don't really need growth, like greenhouses. We don't really need people. We need people for support. I should remember we got into trouble last game because we neglected support for too long. So one of the best ways to accomplish that might just be, like, you know, making sure we always have a cluster of 3 houses with a support building in the middle so that people are reasonably happy about life. So let's give that a shot. So we can do, like, house, house, house. We can do science, 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 power, 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 power. And then, like, I don't know, development center, maybe a couple robot hubs to get his perk going. And then something over here I think might work out okay. We'll give it a shot. So start me off with something like that. I'm seeing titanium right at the start. I love that. Let's grab that first. Second titanium. Nice. And then a little bit of nitrates. I don't exactly have a plan for nitrates yet, but I'm sure I can work something out. So let's export you to import you, and then we'll allocate 1 trit per turn towards our space project. You gotta love starting with a thermo generator, I think. Do I need the science? No, like, both of these are pretty good, and I'd want to take them right away. So I'm just gonna grab the thermo generator. Let's check out stuff that's nearby. Holy cow. We can go anywhere we want from there. Would really love a bus station in Wet Katina, then, because I can go, you know, all of these tiles, this tile here, down here, I can all reach with a bus station. It'd be very strong. I would love to see a couple, second tritium, third tritium. I would love to see a couple exploration pips here that actually have tritium on them so that I could spike out one of these thermo generators. We're not seeing it yet, but I'm not saying there's no hope. And then I think you just take the robot hub to get his perks going. And then with this extra trade route, I think you do like this, so that we actually do get a little bit of extra tritium. So robot hubs, I think up here is a pretty natural spot to put 2 of them. We'll get you up there, get on that nitrate mine, and now we can actually trade nitrates away instead of power, which I think is slightly preferable. And then we do have a small hint of tritium. This is going to be a colossal city in terms of expansion tiles. I think it's just going to be a lot of robots, I think. Like, the robot perk looks nice. We'll do robot. We will need, like, a little bit of science production, so I'll put, like, one science lab in here and then a development center. I think both of these will be robot hubs as well. So anytime we see a robot hub, I think we want to take it. It's just going to be really strong. None of these do anything. Hospital's fine, but we're a long ways away from it in terms of science. So why don't you innovate? Yeah, I would much rather have that. And now I actually need to build my titanium up. So let's stop trading that for a little while. I would love an exploration satellite. I would... I guess Amarsha's like, okay. We do kind of want to get people on the ground. What's up, Azure? I do just kind of want to get boots on the ground here a bit. And Amarsha will help us do that. Titanium will also help us do that. So I think I'm going here. And we got 10. That's beautiful. So now we can do this. We can do this. We'll save one expansion tile for when we see a bus station. And then with the exploration satellite, give me tritium so that I can build this. I'd say that's a pretty strong series of opening turns. Am I okay with my trade routes? I am okay with my trade routes. Don't think I need it. There's going to be a lot of population in that city. I will just take more robots, though. This is not because we even need the expansion tiles. It's honestly because it's going to give us plus one science. So we'll get that in there. Now we can trade away science instead of power. And then what do I need resources-wise? I need more tritium. So I think I want to explore tritium tiles. It's only plus two, but that's okay. We'll take it. And it found more. This is a potentially pretty good city spot then, because that should be a tritium mine. This will be... I think that's usually geothermal power, when it's like just power and nothing else that you find on the map tile. And then I just want to see a bus station, man. Plus two support for every robot in the city. So there's six robots in that city right now. That's 12. So that's actually a lot of support. So I'll take that for sure. And then you just come over here, and now we don't really have to worry about support that much. And this is going to be a robot too. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful thing. I have so much support that I think I can afford to do this. And then next turn we probably do energy savings, just so we can get that mine built immediately. It doesn't really advance our goals of space projects. That is like a side synergy. We're going to need trade routes. And we haven't set any up yet. And that doesn't do anything. So improved spaceflight is really like the only thing we could take there that does something. And then here, I think I do take one lab just to get some science production going. We'll say you can go there. Now, exploration, we go here. We get at least four tritium so that we can do this. We continue advancing our power goals. We energy save so that we can build this mine. And then honestly, we're at plus five support. I think we go here. And next turn we build a mine on a silicates deposit. I just want more stuff. I'm fine with this. Next turn, I think we start trading away silicates after we build that mine instead of science. But for now, I think I'm fine with this. Ingenuity Center is way more exploration than we need right now. But public baths, on the other hand, we're not really doing anything with our water right now. So if we were to get a little bit more water, which we could find here, 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 and a big one down here. We could set up a public baths, and that's a little bit of extra support. I don't think I'm going to need the Ingenuity Center. I think we're going to be just fine on exploration tiles. And I don't need a fourth tritium generator. And I think I'm not going to have power to explore this turn, actually, so why don't we just innovate? We'll just see if we see anything better. And I would say a research center is better just so we see more projects. So now we do this. And then we do this. And that's going to let us build this science up so we can get to the research center, so we can get to improve spaceflight, so that we can start to get some of this stuff rolling. So Gustav's done great for us. How important is Thomas's ability to mine? I'm going to say probably not that important. What would we mine? Probably titanium. Yeah, it's the only mine you have. So how important would it be for us to mine titanium when we're getting plus two per turn? I don't think like that important. On the other hand, all that we need life forms for this game is improving support. It's not really going to advance any of our space goals. And I kind of sleep on silicates boost, but I also like kind of sleep on efficient bacteria spreaders. I don't know. I like the life spreading mechanics. I'm going to take Misha, but it's not like because I actually think it's going to do wonders for us in this game. And then if we import a life form, we should, yeah, we get a bacteria spreader for free. So let's do that. And now we really got to up our science production a bit. I can still research a project. Okay, fair. I would absolutely. I don't know where a high location is yet, so I could just like plunk it down here and move it later, I guess. I'll do that. I gotta remember that moving a building is free. You can really just do it whenever you want. Trade away a little bit of power just because we're starting to produce a lot of it. Okay, I didn't take public baths, so we don't need water. Titanium we're fine on. Power we're also fine on, so actually, I'm just going to take the water so that we can bank it. We might end up using it later, and then I would love a robot hub. I would really love to have two picks there, because I also would have liked to have the entertainment center, but we're okay on support, so I don't necessarily need it right now. That's like a, I'd like to have it in the future, but I don't need it right now. We'll grab this water. It's just a regular aquifer. That's fine. I don't want to do bacteria spreader first. I think I want to do research center first, just because seeing extra projects is good. So let's sit on that for a bit. This is not that important. Give me the one more turn. James, what's up? Thanks for the follow. Am I sure I wish to end this turn? No, I want to use something. What do I want to use? I think I just want to go explore. Can I? No, I can't, because I'm getting two power next turn, and I want to build a robot hub for extra support. So I don't actually want to do that. Let's just import life forms again. Yeah, just give me a forest. We'll bank the plant spreader for later. We'll take the pine forest. Now we start to get our trade routes. I'll definitely take that. I will definitely put you down. And that's mostly for support. And then I'll also put you down. And that's just to see more projects. I guess I probably should have done that in a different order, but that's okay. And then we really want to keep our eyes out for this bus station, but I think we're good to just kind of start expanding once we have power. So I guess one more time we'll import. Hairs are pretty easy to manage, so I think I'll do that. If we even get there. Resonant station we definitely want eventually. No question about that. Delivery drones is a pretty nice support building, but I think we're going to be good on tile expansions. School is also a pretty good support building, and it does contribute a little bit of extra science. And like power's tight right now, but it's not that bad. I think my bigger issue right now is that I don't have enough science to do everything I want to do, so I will take a school. 6, 7. I would love to explore a silicate style this turn to get 3 of them. Even 2 would be okay. Because I can just swap this out really quick. And then we can build you next turn. And we can start to get some science going. I would love a second landing pad. Would I love any of these other buildings? Not really. So I'll just take a second landing pad. School here. And then we can also build our Marsha. So support is fine. We are not worried about support at all. We are just chilling on that. I want to grab one more tritium so that I can build this. And now the only thing we need for Wet Katina is the resonance station. So we'll swap this back over because we don't actually know where it is yet, and we do want to finish this space project. Yeah, I don't have enough banked. And then we do have enough power to just start exploring again. I would like to do a place that's only two away, so that if there is something there to mine, I can mine it without people getting too unhappy. So I guess that would be here. And then I can expand to you, and next turn I can mine you. It's actually just like a much better support building. I'm also going to need a development center eventually, though. I am going to want one of those eventually. Let's grab it for eventually, then. Because we've already got the support building down. I don't want to replace it that quickly. I want to let the science roll in for a little bit. And here... Again, like, I have so many other science buildings that I want to put the bacteria spreader down, but I just don't know when it's going to happen. So let's explore here. Support has increased, but that's okay. We're chilling. This is robots. I wouldn't mind replacing one of our houses in our main city with the combined living center, because it's plus one robots. But I would also, like, rather have power. So I think we do that. I think we do this, just to get an extra trade route. And we'll just allocate it to our space project. And then I think we do this. And I think we do... Yeah, we don't... Well, we could expand to a tile. Hang on. Are any of these elevated? No. I mean, there are, but the mines are on all of them. So next turn, I'd like to expand, like, there. Here's our bus station, finally. So it's, even though there's a science project sitting right here, I think we take the bus station just for what it's going to do for the long-term prospects of this game. I really wish I could have taken both of them, but we'll see more science projects. We're scaling pretty well right now, so I'm not too worried about that. I would love to find a map hex that has science, so let's grab you. Let's expand to you. Let's get more power going. And then I'd like to use the exploration satellite on tritium. And then next turn, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, -1, 6. Next turn I can build the bus station. Although I should probably figure out where it's going to go. It's like not a lot of places for it. I think it's going to replace this laboratory. I know I said science was important, but it's not that important. Am I good with these trades? I don't think I need to be doing that anymore. We only need... No, I do need to... It would drop to 5. So I need to import 1. And then I need to... I can import one other thing. What else do I want? Let's start working on food. No, let's start working on science, because we're really gated on science right now. Here, I think I can afford to take a space project. And it's really helped out by the fact that it's a lot of stuff that we produce very easily. So now we do bus station. That fixes a lot of our support issues that we had for overextending here. And it also means that we can start to go even further beyond. So I think I would... Never mind, I'm out of power. I think I would take my cyanophyta and let it spread just a little bit faster. And then I gotta get rid of this, and I gotta do that, just so we can finish that project this turn. Actually, this creates 3 trade routes. If I wait to finish this for just like a turn or two, I actually get 6 support from finishing it, so I'm going to do that. We'll just let it sit there almost done. Here we go. Now we're rolling space projects. 2 science per turn would let us replace a lot of our planet-side-based science production. And we don't do a whole lot else with silicates right now, so that seems like a pretty easy grab. I'm good on landing pads. I don't need another one. And as much as I would like to work on terraforming parameters, I'd rather have something that, like, contributes to our economy. I'd also really love to upgrade all the robot hubs to Android hubs, but I think that's a ways off in terms of our current production. So let's do that. Next turn we can do this, and then we can finish that project. So we'll do that, and then we can just finish it in the same turn. And then I do have enough power to keep exploring. So let's grab all of these 2 power exploration sites. That we can just expand to right away and do a viewpoint tower on. Get a little bit of bonus comfort, I think, is what the canyons do. Svetlana, unfortunately, we've expanded that city beyond where she would be useful. We don't produce enough food to do hab modules or skyscrapers. Jan makes our dikes cheaper, and that's about it. These are 2 pretty bad leader picks. Because I don't really know how I'm going to make use of either of these, but like, I guess it's slightly more likely that I would make dikes. We're not making nitrogen factories. We don't have the space for a power breathing center. And we can only overwork once. Yeah, I'll take Jan. Train station is interesting, but a little expensive right now. But then nothing here is really better. So I guess I'll take it. Now, finish you, enable you, and then we've got all the trade routes we could ever want. So let's stop this and just focus completely on getting some of these trade routes finished up. Jan, I think all you're going to do here for us during your tenure is explore and give us extra science. Just to prepare you for the responsibilities of your job. And then what are the other resources we need right now? Science, primarily. So we could hit that for some science. Take a little bit of free food along with it. And I would actually like to get this city up pretty soon, I think. I don't think there's a whole lot of other things here that are that interesting to expand to. Although I guess we could just expand over some of these city tiles, because Wet Katina is going to be able to get really big. But here, like within bus range, you've got a large trit deposit, you've got an aquifer, you've got geothermal, and then if there's anything out here, you've got access to it as well. I think that makes sense. We need 10 more food. I don't have the trade routes for 10 more food right now. So I'll just skip it. I do not have the food to found Phobos either right now, so that's going to have to wait. I guess I should probably start taking buildings that produce food to work in the second city that we set up. I think my cunning gambit of what happens if you never build a greenhouse is kind of starting to stifle our growth a bit. So let's start working on that. Yeah, geothermal spot. We could turn that into a spa resort for a bunch of happiness. You've also got a silicates deposit in the city, which is kind of neat. And then you can expand. Like, you could just expand along the top of that. What does it get us right now? An extra trade route? It's not nothing. Okay. More likely that we do a temperate forest, I think, than artificial bacteria. Unlikely, I would say. This is a science project, though, so we could just take that. It's a pretty easy one, too. So let's knock that out. Let's get a exploration underway. We are saving up for a development center right now. I don't know where it's going to go, though. I don't think I can fit it in this city. So maybe I do just do the bacteria spreader now. I also see a highland. So I think we take that. We move you to here. And then we put you here. And then we have you start doing some terraforming. That should be fine. Titanium per turn if oxygen's above zero. That's not going to happen for a while. I do see a second farm, though, so I probably take that in preparation for this next city. Plus two trit is great. I'll repair that with silicates, and then I will finish this project, and then I'll start working on this project. So we're doing great already. Like, we're already at 40 of 150 on science projects. It's only turn 24. We have a pretty robust economy at this point. This city expansion will be nice. I don't think it's that necessary, but it is just kind of giving us something to do. I feel good. I feel like we're in really nice shape on this one. Where's a tile that I can explore for 2 power? You have exhausted all of them. You only have 3 power tiles left? That's fine. Grab some nitrates and some water. What do I need? Power, really, for the train station. But science isn't that bad either. New scientific fields. Whenever you permanently increase the amount of projects you can research per turn, science is also increased. So we're about to get a plus one out of that. It's plus one science for free for building our development center. I think it's a little late to start on artificial personality. But I also don't like reverse engineering. I think selling a project to get a science is kind of important. New scientific fields is cheaper, so I guess we'll take that. I really wish that I could take both of these this turn. But we are about to get plus two science out of our orbital lab, so I think that means a spaceport is more important. Finish you. Allocate everything to you. Set up new scientific fields. Select a life form. I like plankton. I'm a plankton fan. And then are we saving power up for anything? Yes, kind of. We're saving it up for a spaceport, which is probably going to go here. Because then we get a free silicates trade route out of it. But we're a long ways off. And I don't want to spend power to go too far after it. Well, we are making 6 per turn. I think I can afford to grab one that's just that's 3 power away. I don't think that really breaks the bank for us. Second development center synergizes pretty well with that project that we finished. Don't have immediate plans to build it, but I would like having it around. I'd love to have this around. Pretty sure that's going to be more than 8 projects. Yeah. Okay, an animal spreader is the least likely thing that gets built here. And then with these free trade routes, I think we start in on building up our food to make another city. Continue grabbing things that cost 3. Nothing else we can really afford. This is food. So I'll grab it. That's science. And now we're out of space projects, which is great. 28, 29, 30. I'll trade away 2 power to make that happen. And then what else do I need? Science. Do like a little bit of that. You can come down here and get silicates for the train station, I would say. And then you can continue exploring 3-cost tiles. Oh, there's our food. Okay, well, we don't even need to do this anymore. Now what the hell do we trade for? Silicates, probably. 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Next turn we can explore to get 22 for Resonant Station. And then that's just like a lot of water. Actually, this is a lot of nitrates. We can just trade something like that. So found me here. New Jakarta? Sure. What's our configuration look like here? I think we could do food, 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 soil factory, miscellaneous buildings, miscellaneous building, house, 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 support. Yeah, that seems pretty good. And then remove this, and then we put you here, we put you here, we put you here, and then we're also looking for a soil factory now. Also, robot hubs. Place needs to expand. No soil factory, no robot hub, but a support building. We like that. Oh, we could also just build you like a train station to expand, I guess. What if this was a train station? What if this was a train station? Since we can't destroy that because we don't have the power. And then we go, yeah. Yeah. Geothermal plant is pretty tempting, but I think our power is going to take off once we get this resonant station up. So give me the spa resort instead. Take me down here for an aquifer, and then take me over here for, you know, just a random building. And then you need to explore for silicates this turn. You don't have the power to explore. Oh, never mind. We spent it all. What did we spend it all on? The train station. Right. Okay. So we need to work our way back up to 22. And then we also got to get this spaceport down one of these days. But I'm still feeling good. I'm not afraid. We could put a speculative linked nitrogen factory here. Actually, how cold is it here? -1. So it's just a -1 comfort of living. I don't think a power breathing center is going to be that impactful. Give me this, because these and these might also be able to be linked nitrogen factories, which would be decent for atmosphere production. Not seeing anything I love here. Second bacteria spreader is probably what I'm most excited about, but we have 40 science that's currently allocated towards development centers. A public bath is pretty good, but we just took an entertainment center, which is way cheaper and almost as good. Could do a hydroponic farm, but we spent all of our water. And, well, we could do a homestead. Yeah. Yeah, we could do a homestead, because we're getting food now. So you turn into a mine. Next turn, we are at 20 silicates. If I could find a large silicate deposit, like, can't afford you, you're probably not going to have 4, but you might have 2. You had 3. Next turn, we can build you with no help. So we don't need to trade for silicates this turn. We should probably trade for science this turn. 18, 19, 20. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 13, 17. And I can't trade away silicates. I can't trade away... I could trade away a little titanium, not that much, though. I think I could do something like that. These choices do not matter. They're both animals. Actually, I should probably do that. That is going to screw up our power for next turn. So instead we do that. So this is at 15. We can build spaceport. This will be at 10, so we can build spaceport. This will be at 23, so we could build resonant station. Could actually trade one away, and we could still build resonant station. This will be at 20, so we can build development center. I guess water is the one thing we should trade away, because we literally can't afford to trade anything else away. Next turn is going to be huge. We got a big old turn coming up. That's a space project, so we just kind of take it on site. It doesn't really matter what it does, we just want it. And then I think we just want another spaceport. So you go here. You give us a free mine, but you also give us plus one comfort of living in Wet Katina, which is really what we were after. You go here, you give us plus three power. Don't really have to think about power that much anymore. We're in a great spot. And then you can't go here because I need to build a house here. Fair. So I guess we're looking for homesteads next. Get rid of you. Take your free trade route. I don't have that much titanium. Okay. I could satellite for titanium, though. Do we have any big titanium deposits, or is it just that little one? It's just the little one, so I'll grab either of them, I guess. So now we can do that. We have one free import. We'll put that towards food. And then for our second import, I don't know. Second spaceport is probably what we should be working on. Oh, you're out of expansion tiles. That's unfortunate for us. So I wanted to go here, get the Link Nitrogen Factory up. What do I want to do with this last trade route? I think I can get rid of nitrates for sure. And I guess bring titanium in, because you're going to need titanium for this homestead. And Jan, you have no power. I don't think you do anything this turn, bud. I think you're just going to be support. I think we fix that. We're kind of overdoing that. We're also kind of overdoing that. But innovate is good. We're probably done with that. This is just terraforming parameters. I take Henry a lot. But it's like mostly because he's just really good. I think this is the one time we actually should probably just take innovate. And then you're a space project. So I think we just take you. And then we're trying to get this homestead done, because the homestead is what's going to give us more tiles we could expand to here. I would like you to explore this spot. Trade routes are fine as is, I think. Yeah, I think we just leave those where they're at for right now. Do you have anywhere that you need to expand? Not really, it's just for empty tiles. Are there any empty tiles that make your mines go insane? Yes, actually. We expand here, we get another free trade route out of the silicates, and we get a free water trade route. Well, then we just don't get water. I'd rather not do that. Here is appealing, but I don't think we can afford to expand out that far, because we have 28 support. We could expand anywhere we wanted to, realistically. And there's a large nitrates deposit. Okay. You've convinced me. This is where our next spaceport is going, right here. Whenever we have the resources for that. Don't think I'm going to need a third one. This is an impressively expensive space project, but that's good, because like that's our goal. So we do that. We finish you. Now let's take a quick break to actually get this homestead down, because we're just kind of burning time putting all this into space projects when we could really be accelerating production over here. So 25, 28, 30, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we're going to get more. We have a ton. I don't know where all these nitrates are coming from, but happy to have them. And then I do think that you just explore this turn. Slightly more likely we build a boreal rainforest, I would say. This is power. We love that. I'd also love to take... I can't take both. I don't have the slots. So we'll take the solar panels, reset all of our trade, keep the free one. We'll stick it on food for now. Why not? then come in here, destroy you. You go here. And now we can finally put down our development centers. Which I'm going to say you can go there. And then we can research a second project. I guess we'll just... Will I? No, because the silicates are being competed for right now. I could innovate, is what I could do. Could innovate into... like, not really anything that good. A temporary urban planning office in New Jakarta would actually be not terrible. That increases our building limits. We could put down, like, the second development center in there. And then you also got an expansion out of that. Let's grab that empty tile. It could be like a spaceport or a rocket pad whenever we get it. Don't think that choice is going to matter. And what do we need right now? I really don't think we need a whole lot. I'll just grab titanium when I see it because we're kind of low on it. But I don't think we need it. I think we're just kind of set. Here's our soil factory that we wanted. So we grab that. The rest of these... If I didn't have Innovate, I think I'd just take windmills and put it on that new empty tile we grabbed. But because I do have Innovate, I think I innovate. This is so far away. This we don't have space for. Another research center is not terrible, I guess. But I think I'd... Well, would I? Is that true? I was going to say I think I'd rather build the second development center first, but I don't know if I agree with that. Maybe I would just rather have a research center. Oh, I could also build this mine. Probably could have done that a while ago. So let's get soil factory down. Let's get research center down. Let's also get this down for just some extra support. And then we don't have enough tritium in stock? Okay, well then we'll scale this back until it works, and then we'll put a bunch of silicates into another project. Building to spread... Oh, a lifeform action. Fair. Let's come up here. I'm thinking. Thinking how many tiles we would get out of Wet Katina if we took the Robot Ingenuity Center. I'm pretty sure there is an achievement for, like, expand to a ton of tiles, so let's try and go for that. We'll take the Robot Expansion Center. And then, the rest of these are, like, pretty underwhelming. They're still pretty underwhelming. Don't have space for you where I would just take it. It's basically free with 4 tritium per turn. I'll just turn you into science. Now, I don't know where this is going to go. Maybe it'll go on top of the research center because we just built another one. I don't really want to replace anything else. I guess I could replace like 1 tritium thermogenerator if I wanted to. We are making 10 per turn. That's probably pretty good. And now we are fully out of tritium. So you drop all the way to 4. And then we'll run you for a while. You should really just like focus on 1. I don't think that's really going to happen this game, so I'll just take a free 5 science. I think I'll take a spaceport, and I think I will take an innovate. Beach club? No, not really. Quantum data center? Also not really. Don't think I need any of those. And then you come in here, we get 8 expansion tiles. So we go here. Water mine. We go... We'll take all the ones that are just -1. How about that? I don't know which one. You're going to be a -1. Yeah. You'll be a -1. These over here are actually not even a -1. They're just 0. Oh, there it is. Metropolis. Let's see what that was. Yeah, have a city that owns 20 locations. There you go. Achievement unlocked. Trade route's not assigned. Oh, because we finished that. Okay. Well, then put the silicates into here. That's all we can afford. Two spare trade routes. Give me extra tritium and trade away nitrates to do it. I can't do anything on you yet. I would like to do an agricultural complex. It's a little ways away. But I don't think I need the nitrates mine because we've got that nitrates deposit sitting over there. So now I'm looking for, like, second train station. Oh, you're not done. I thought you were done this turn. But you were not done this turn. I think I just innovate. I actually don't even think I need to innovate. I think I'd rather explore here and start working towards expanding there. We could also expand there. Could also expand there and here. There's a lot of expansion we could still do. Take seagrass, though. I could also get this plant spreader down pretty soon, probably. So what if we don't do that? What if we do like that instead? Oh, but you're like a free trade route. That's pretty valuable. We could afford to do that. And I can still research a project. Right, I never made this decision. Our water is currently allocated for something that I was going to spend it on that I just currently can't remember. Well, it probably means that it's just not allocated then, doesn't it? Yeah, fair point. Could also just take, like, a house. I'll just take a house. So we've got space for one more house over here. We're a ways off of it, but we'll get it down eventually. And now we get to pick one of these science projects. So let's finish you. Plus support. Let's... take you are probably going to be easier to finish. Because our silicates are spread real thin across those other two projects right now. And then I'll just turn the other one into science. You're going to be done. We can afford to do all of that. That's great news. And then I can put this plant spreader down. And I can actually spread a boreal forest. A tundra forest. Sorry, not even a boreal forest. Any 3 cost? There's 1 3 cost. We'll take that. And then we're waiting on, like, maybe tritium to build spaceports. We could just, like, put down a second development center. I guess, excuse me? Oh, you're full! Okay, we need to put a house down then. How far away are we from this? We get it next turn. Sure, I will take one turn off. I will come back to pick those space projects. You go here, and now you can go here. And then, what are the space projects we want this turn? Exploration satellites, or plus 2 support income per new space project you complete? That's probably going to be highly unnecessary, but it doesn't compete for silicates, and our silicates are still recovering, so we take it. And then there's an outside chance we place a combined living center, but I actually think this game is about to end, because we are very close to winning. So that's 7, 8, 9. It's going to be a little while before that one's done. This one, on the other hand, I think we can wrap up pretty soon. So let's cancel those two. Start allocating that. We still have a lot to do. You have one free expansion. But you also have a train station, don't you? Or did we just give you a bus station? No, you're a train station. Which means that you can reach out here for this large nitrate mine. And then we can still perform an action with our leader. Well, we have plenty of power, so we'll just go grab even more nitrates. Plus 1 science per 3 robots. It's a little late. A docks. It's a little under terraformed. So I guess I would just innovate and see nothing else we really want. So I'll just take science. I should probably, like, instead of doing that, I should be exploring for silicates so I could rush these projects faster, I think. in a closer game, I think those would be misplays. This is not a closer game, though. Mariam, thank you for your work. Ayokunle, I don't see an ocean mine in your future. A free docks is, like, pretty sick, but I don't see that in your future either. But then, do I see Flora doing anything useful? Not really either. But whatever. Alright, so if you explore a silicate, then over here we can do that so that that project finishes next turn. This project finishes next turn. That should be the game. That should be the game finished. Take one of you, turn the rest into science, end turn. Sure. Think about it later. Enable. Enable. Yeah. Turn 42, baby. Very nice. Very, like, sane and good gameplay. Kind of ashamed that we struggled so much with the previous game that we played after putting on that masterful performance, but, you know, what can you do? We've unlocked new leaders. What do you do? Field research, Eureka. Eureka's so good on a tier 1 leader. Unity of the... That's also really good. Holy cow. So she's like a bus station that doesn't give expansion tiles. And then what do you do? Marleywood Studio... Nature document. Okay, so you're a support Marty. Yeah, you are a big support Marty. So this is like if something's gone catastrophically wrong at the end of your game, you can take to Zvetan. Also, we've reached max level apparently. As we unlocked everything that we need to unlock. Is that what this means?